Now and ever into ages of ages. God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call and remember for all holy immaculate blessed and glorious, the defense of the Sacred Virgin Mary, with all the saints, and commend ourselves and each other, and all our life, and Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever to ages of ages.
Amen.
Amen. by emulating the ways of glorious bestsellers and following the straight paths of the Baptist. O Father Anthony, you made the desert a city and upheld the world by your prayers. Therefore, entreat, praise God, that our souls may be saved.
On the road leading into the heart, you were the leader, the first and foremost, and the teacher. When you
Sure.
peace be unto all.
And with thy spirit,
wisdom,
give in the tone, tenth, seventh tone. Pray and make your vows before the Lord our God.
Wisdom.
Read the epistle of St. Paul to the Ecclesians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassion, kindness, lowliness, meekness, and patience, forbearing one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all of these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as you teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God.
Peace be unto you as read to us.
And with thy spirit.
Alleluia.
The Son of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed Saint Sabbath Day feast to everyone. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ. I was thinking about Saint Sabbath actually on Monday, the day of my surgery. as I was laying on the table waiting for the operation, and wondering how a young man in his teenage years gave up being the prince of the Serbian nation. His father, of course, was King Stefan then on him. Saint Sava gave up all of that, the power, the fame, the riches, the wealth, begged his parents to let him go to the monastery as a teenager. Think about that for a second. Think about your own teen years. Kind of embarrassing, huh? But Saint Sava was the type of man that we well know. If you've read anything about Saint Sava, you know that his first priority was to serve God in everything he did. His brothers were warring and in conflict with one another. His first priority was to bring them to Christ. He sat down with them and mediated and brokered a truce and peace between his own family. By contrast, in the Gospel this morning, we have the young ruler, the young lawyer, excuse me, who wanted to test Jesus. Right? What do I have to do to inherit eternal life? Jesus, of course, known in our hearts, said to him, you have to keep all the commandments. Just imagine that young lawyer looking around as Christ is saying, do not kill, do not steal, do not. He's looking at his friends. Oh, yeah. Done all that. Woo! Done all that. I'm in my tent, right, Master? No. Then go and sell all that you have and give it to the poor. Boom. The young lawyer is convicted of his own greed, of his own desires, of his own need. Just like every time we put our desires and our needs first before Christ, before serving him, it doesn't work out. Never does. Please allow me to give you a simple example of my own life. Again, back to Monday. It's a hard day in my life. I'm laying on the table waiting for the operation. I did all my prayers. Did the third hour, the sixth hour, the ninth hour. From memory. Patting myself on the back. Wow, no luck. Yes! Because the doctor said 2 o'clock, we're going in. 2:15, the doctor comes in and says, nah, we have a problem. The laser machine's not here. I go back to my prayer. Okay, well, start again. Get to the ninth hour. Yes! Doctor comes back in. Still a problem. The truck broke down. We'll try to get it there as soon as possible. I go back to my prayers. What else can you do? I really have no idea. I thought, okay. Forget all these prayers. Not working. Lord, with tears, I said, I give up. It's in your hands. If it's meant to be, it's going to happen. If it's not, it's not. Take care of me. And he did. A lot of times we can fool ourselves, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, into thinking. We know the answer. We know the way. God has different plans. And his plan for us is, of course, to be saved. That's why this gospel is so rich for us today. He doesn't want us to put things in front of him that are in our life, right? I mean, let's be honest, like the young lawyer. How much can we have until we're satisfied? How big does our house have to be? How much money do we have to have? How much good health do we have to have? We're all going to die. Every one of us. Right? Yet we live life in total, forgive me, but fear of getting sick, getting healthy, whatever. Why? Our goal is to live eternally with Christ. That's it. We have to find a way to put all those barriers aside that prevent us from serving God in our life. More importantly, to find ways being Christ-like to those in our lives. Because when we serve them, we're serving God. So back to Monday, after the surgery, I said a prayer of thanks. There's a prayer in the priest's book of needs, recovery from surgery. I said that prayer. I thank God for the doctor, for his patience. T-I-E-N-C-E, not T-I-E-N-T-S. For his patience. He could have left, he had an emergency at Jefferson Hospital to go to. He didn't. He stayed. He wanted to see it through. We have to be careful not to take God for granted when he does it in our life. And more importantly, when we realize what he's doing in our life, show us our thanks by serving him. But by all means, be thankful. God bless you.
Let us say with our whole soul, with our own minds, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Almighty, God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God. According to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. William, Frank, Luann, Lilisa, Robert, Mildred, Ralph, Janet, Lord, by cold, we are not world by sleep in the Lord.
Lord,
visitation for the servants of God, Nicola, William, Joanne, Ava, Katie, Daniela, Helen, Steve, Beverly, Mila, Melba, Laura, William, Melba, Nancy, Eugene, Dorothy, Margaret, Tanya, Joseph, Fanny, Gregory, Jubin, Maria, Mariana, Heather, Becky, Betsy, Priest Rodney, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable house, for those who labor, those who sing, for all the people in the present, who wait by great and rich mercy.
Thank you.
return to the Christ and the Holy Spirit, now is our prayers. Let us in this room return to the Christ and the Holy Spirit, now is our prayers.
To ages.
faith, purpose, and fear of God and therein. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance from all future wrath, hatred, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. An angel, peace, a faithful guide, guard of our souls and bodies. Let us ask of the Lord.
And hear, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, all things that are good and profitable for our souls, and peace for the world. Let us ask of the Lord.
And hear, O Lord.
We may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance. The Christian ending to our life, painless, painless, peaceful. A good defense for the church, judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask of the Lord. Call on your parents for all the holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in our life to Christ our God.
To
thee,
O Lord.
For the compassion of the only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever to ages of ages. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Thank you. singing a triumphant hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and singing. Send down the Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts are offered. And may this bread the precious body of thy Christ. Amen. And now it's in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ. Amen. Amen. May you the chain by the Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 That they may be the day for the gifts of the soul, remission of sins, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom, and the boldness for the unfettered condemnation. Again, help the priest of worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith. Ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, and saints. And every righteous spirit make perfect in faith. Easily unknown, Pesciatia, the chief of the Solania, Slava, the deeds of natural words of faith, and Jeremy, Thank you. sanctifying the word of thy truth.
Amen.
Now, brethren, with one mouth and one heart, we praise the majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever to ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ shall be with all of you. The kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever to ages of ages. Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Lift our heads unto the Lord.
Through the grace and compassion and love toward mankind, the begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, giveth all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Amen.
The holy things are for the holy.
Together to start the prayer before Holy Communion. I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art King of the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, and whom I confess. I believe also that this is truly thine own most of your body, this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive me my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committing knowledge and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of the most of mysteries, to the remission of my sins, until life everlasting. Amen. O thou mystical supper, O Son of God, extend me today as a communicant, for I speak of thy mystery for the enemies, neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. And give me thy holy mysteries, for neither to my judgment, nor to my condemnation, O Lord, to you in the soul and body. thanksgiving to yourself when you receive Holy Communion. Also, please state your baptismal name when you come to the chalice.
Thank you.
Jackson, commemorating the venerable Anthony the Great, father of monasticism, this day of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for his good and loves mankind. Don Voyne to celebrate his birthday. Don, how old?
94.
94! Lord have mercy. We're both on the right side, so honestly. Today's Nick Chick Crescent's birthday. Where is he? Chicky. How old?
94. 62.
God bless you. Joanne, do you have your birthday today?
No, it's not
27. It's not a day.
27,
that's right. And you're not 95, right?
No.
62.
No. So
I'm 79. Oh, God bless you. Debbie, what are his birthdays today?
Thank you, not after.
Okay, please join us downstairs for our Saints on the Banquet. Not on here, sorry.
February
2nd.
February 2nd.
Oh, February 2nd.
This coming Wednesday.
This coming Wednesday.
Yes.
Charles, how old?
76.
Yeah. Woo! You guys are awesome. Join us downstairs for our Saints Alpha Banquet, our program, our Jeopardy program. It is open for all of you audience people, so you'll be able to ask the questions. And see how we do. Tuesday is number baking for our women at 9:30.
And men.
And men, yes, men as well. Men are not exempt. This coming Sunday, the Eastern Diocesan Executive Board will be meeting here after church. So please welcome them for that. Thursday, February the 10th, a week from this Thursday, we will have our first choir rehearsal to rehearse for Bishop Ian to come to visit with us. Understand something, because I know I've gotten some pushback about why there's so few children participating in St. Saturday. Understand a couple of things. One, there's still COVID going around. I talked to three families this week that are still dealing with COVID, so they're not coming. The cold weather has something to do with it. That's just the reality of it. But the other thing is, there are several parishes in our diocese that are doing St. Saba Day virtually. I'm not even having anything in person. So I'm very thankful that we're able to come together as family, to be with one another, and to celebrate St. Saba. So God bless you. Okay? Special thanks to my dear brother in Christ, Father Ned Djokovic, who is literally a lifesaver for us. Thank you, Father Deacon. It's always a joy to serve with you. And let's have a choir so many years. Grateful and peaceful life, God's salvation, for there was all good things. To these thy servants, the servant of God, Donald, Charles, Nicola, the handmaiden, Dolores, Joanne, and Deborah, their family, friends, and loved ones, preserve them, O Lord, for me.
Yeah.
you to Vinny and Vanessa, which is Rick Serkovich, for taking down our Christmas decorations. Thank you guys, it was wonderful.